Do you really have to fight, like, right now? Say hi. Say hi. I promise to stop attacking Heidi. Because I'm a good cat and I can behave. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and another video. So as I mentioned in my previous video, 2019 has been a shit of a year for reading. I have read some not so great books. I haven't really read much that's sort of blown my mind. It's been really disappointing and that sucks because I just want to have a decent reading year. I just want to have a month of reading where I read more than one book. Is that so difficult? So today I thought I would go through some of the worst books that I've read this year. These aren't necessarily horrible books, but they were low ratings for me and books that I necessarily did not enjoy as much as a lot of other people have. I thought, let's just share this. Let's enjoy being negative because 2019 has been a negative year. I will also be doing a best books of 2019, but you can't have the good without the bad. So I'm starting off with the bad and then we'll have the good later on. But today this video is all negative. Any of these books that I mention, I don't mean for anybody to take it personally. It's just my opinion on these books because I know some of these books are fairly popular. Alright, let's get into it, shall we? So these aren't in the order of how much I hated them. It's just in the order that I read them, just to make it easier. So the first one that I read in 2019 and really did not like was actually part of a book club that I had been a part of at the beginning of the year, which I am no longer a part of now, but long story short, this book was the first book that we had read and we were meant to put our review on Amazon and Goodreads as well because we got the book for free. So the first book is The Girl Without Magic by Megan O. Russell. I think I gave it 3 stars, I think. This series now, I believe, is all about our main character, Maggie Trent. And at the beginning of this book, she falls from what I believe is our world, where she's in a battle. She falls from that into what's called the Siren's realm. So at first she thinks she's dead and trapped wherever she is. Like, she doesn't know if she's in heaven or if she's in hell. So she goes from this battle to the Siren's realm, and the Siren's realm is like this magical, fantastical realm with all these strange things going on, like weird weather, weird people, weird things on a daily basis. Like, it's just chaos, essentially. And it takes a while for you to adapt and get used to it. It's very interesting world building, I will give it that. But it also did not make a lot of sense to me sometimes. And also, I felt like I was reading a sequel. I felt like I was thrown into this book feeling like I needed to know all about our main character's backstory and all about her life. Like, I feel like I already knew that. Like, we were already meant to know that. I was just so confused. I was like, am I reading the second book in this series? Like, what's going on? Because you're sort of just thrown into this, you don't really know, like, what's going on. You're sort of confused. There were some parts of the story that were relatively interesting enough, but all in all, it was rather boring and sort of all over the place. The characters were also very uninteresting, and I couldn't quite get on board the chemistry that there was meant to be between two certain characters, and it just felt like a mess, essentially. I just, like, there were some things that I thought were okay. Like, it was definitely a very original story, and there were some aspects of her writing that I could enjoy. Like, she was very good at descriptions and stuff like that, but I couldn't get my head around the world building. I couldn't enjoy the plot. I didn't like the characters. It was just chaos for me. And I can understand why some people enjoy it, but I did not enjoy it, unfortunately. The second book on my list is a book that has been fairly hyped across Bookstagram and BookTube. I haven't really seen many negative reviews about it, just a lot of positive reviews, but I didn't like it. And that was A Curse So Dark and Lonely by Bridget Camera. I don't even know how to pronounce her last name. So this book is meant to be like a Beauty and the Beast urban fantasy retelling. Our main character goes from the real world into this magical world that has been cursed. I ended up giving this book 3.5 out of 5 stars. I loved the fact that it was Beauty and the Beast inspired, and there were some aspects of this story that were very similar to Beauty and the Beast, which I loved because I love Beauty and the Beast. And I did love the diversity that was thrown into this because the main character has cerebral palsy. My problem with diversity is when it's thrown in unnecessarily. This was okay up to a point. It felt like the first half of the book, it's like, yep, we get it. She's got cerebral palsy. She can't do this. She can't do that. She struggles with this. She struggles with that. And then the second half was like, oh, let's just forget about that. She's normal now. Like, it was just ignored. I don't know. It was a bit weird, and that sort of annoyed me in that aspect. But I did like the fact that there was some diversity in that. That was not just thrown in there for the sake of having diversity, at least for the first half of the book anyway. And I did like our main character, and I did like one of the other characters as well. I didn't really like our main love interest, which makes me think that she's sort of making this story to be like A Court of Thorns and Roses. If you guys know that series and you've read it and you know how that series goes, well, it could be very similar. Kind of feels like it's going to be like that. I don't know. I don't plan on reading the next book anyway. The writing was mainly the bad thing about this book. It was just all over the place and irritating. The world building was great. I enjoyed that. The plot was okay. It wasn't really anything special. It was just kind of like meh. I couldn't really understand the hype behind this. I feel like a lot of the hype was because of the said diversity, but meh. Who knows? I just really didn't enjoy it as much as everybody else did. The next one on my list is another hyped up book, The Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller. I also gave this one 3.5 out of 5 stars. Purely because I loved the Greek mythology aspect, but it fell quite flat for me in the end. You know, there were parts of the book that dragged, there were parts that I felt could have been cut out. It just was not as great as I had expected, which happens a lot when you have hyped up books. This particular book follows Patroclus? I never know how to pronounce his goddamn name. Damn Greeks. It follows him and Achilles and their relationship as they grow up from, you know, kids to adults. And their lives together. And it was quite interesting to read about because I like my history, I like my mythology, I love Greek mythology, it's awesome. But this book really just fell flat. It didn't grip me. Like I said, it dragged. The writing was exceptional though. It was perfect. It was just the plot that fell flat and I was just disappointed. I would like to read more of her work, but this book was just disappointing. That's all I really have to say about that one. It was just, the ending fell flat for me. It just wasn't as good as I had expected, of course. The next one I have on my list is The Wren Hunt by Mary Watson. I don't know what to say about this book. I literally cannot remember a thing. It was that bad for me. I was so distracted and so bored and like, I just could not get into it. I was skimming pages. It just did not grip me. And I was so confused. I wasn't sure if this was meant to be like a fantasy or if it was like post-apocalyptic or what was going on. It was just so, so confusing. And I don't remember a single thing about it. I really, really don't. And I don't care. I was reading it and I was like, I really don't know why I'm reading this. I don't care about the characters. I don't care about the plot. The writing is irritating. What the hell is going on? What am I doing? Why am I wasting my time reading this? I saw a lot of great reviews because a lot of people really enjoyed it. But I just didn't. I don't know what it was, but it just was not the book for me. I hate when I get so confused and I'm not sure like what setting this book is meant to be. And it takes me too long to catch up to what the setting is because I want to be thrown into it in that first chapter. I want to know what the setting is in that first chapter. I gave it 3 out of 5 stars anyway. I should have given it less, but I don't really know. Not like I could say much because I didn't remember anything about it. But I'll read you the blurb since I can't really give you a good description of it anyway. But so here's the description of the book. Every Christmas, Ren is chased through the woods near her isolated village by her family's enemies, the Judges, and there's nothing that she can do to stop it. Once her people, the Augurs, controlled a powerful magic, but now that power lies with the Judges, who are set on destroying her kind for good. In a desperate bid to save her family, Ren takes a dangerous undercover assignment as an intern to an influential judge named Cassa Harkness. Cassa has spent her life researching a transformative spell which could bring the war between the factions to its absolute end. Caught in a web of deceit, Ren must decide whether or not to gamble on the spell and seal the Augur's fate. See, it sounds like an interesting enough book, and that's why I picked it up. I was like, it sounds interesting, but like within that first couple of chapters, I was like, what am I doing? Why am I reading this? I really don't like this, but I kept going anyway, didn't I? The second last one I have on my list is On the Road by Jack Kerouac. I did not finish this book. I DNF'd this one, I really did. So obviously I didn't give this a star rating, but this is a classic that I've had on my shelf for a while and I wanted to read it. And at first, because I was listening to it on audiobook and it was interesting. I was like, oh, I really like reading about this guy's travels. Like, he seems really interesting. You know, he's a drifter. I like reading about that sort of stuff. Like, I like hearing about their sort of little adventures and where they're going to next, what they do, that sort of thing. But after a while, I just got bored. I was like, I don't really know what's happening now. Like, where is he now? Who is he talking to? Who's these people? Like, I just kept getting distracted and bored and I just could not connect with any of the characters after a while. It was just like repetitive. Like, can something please happen? At least with Old Mice and Men, in the draggy sort of parts, they mixed it up with exciting things. And it was still a short book in itself anyway, so it wasn't like the parts were dragging too much in that one. But yeah, in On the Road, it was very draggy, very boring. I just did not like it. Yeah, so I DNF'd that one, unfortunately, because I really wanted to read it and I really wanted to like it, but I guess it just was not for me. Maybe one day I'll pick it up again when I'm in the right mood for it, but at this stage, it's just going to stay DNF'd. And the last book so far for this year that I did not like was The Candle and the Flame by, now let me get this right because it's a difficult name to pronounce, Nafisa Azad. I think that's how you pronounce it. I also gave this one 3 stars. Fatima lives in the city of Noor, a thriving stop along the Silk Road. There, the music of myriad languages fills the air, and people of all faiths weave their lives together. However, the city bears scars of its recent past, when the chaotic tribe of Shayateen Jinn slaughtered its entire population, except for Fatima and 2 other humans. Now ruled by a new Maharaja, Noor is protected from the Shayateen by the Ifrit, Jinn of Order and Reason, and by their commander, Zulfikar. But when one of the most potent of the Ifrit dies, Fatima is changed in ways she cannot fathom, ways that scare even those who love her. Oud in hand, Fatima is drawn into the intrigues of the Maharaja and his sister, the affairs of Zulfikar and the Jinn, and the dangers of a magical battlefield. Nafisa Azad weaves an immersive tale of magic and the importance of names, fiercely independent women, and perhaps most importantly, the work for harmony within a city of 1,000 cultures and cadences. So, as you can tell, this is a very cultural story, which I absolutely loved. It was very rich in the culture, but that was also difficult because with a lot of the names, I had to keep going back to the back of the book to look at the glossary and see what the names meant so I could work out what was going on. I didn't really know what to think of this. I sort of lost interest about halfway through. Like, it was very interesting at first and I was like, oh, I want to keep reading more. This is great. But then after a while, I was getting very bored. I just did not like it. I didn't, the writing was bugging me as well, which I say quite a lot, but it's true, it does. You know, when the writing bugs you, you can't really ignore that. I just did not enjoy it after a while. Like, it just became a chore to read, and I knew I had to read it for a book club. This is a different book club than the one I previously mentioned. Don't ask. This, I believe, was the first book from this author, which, congrats to her, that's awesome. But for me personally, I could not connect to the story. I didn't like having to flick to the back of the book to see what was going on to make sense, or at least I wasn't that invested to be able to enjoy doing that. Yeah, I just lost interest in it after a while. I can't explain it. I just got tired of it. And the plot changed so dramatically that I was like, wait, what's going on now? I was sort of losing track of who's who as well in like the different things that were happening in the story. But yeah, these things happen. You read books that you don't necessarily like. It happens. We all do it. I'm just hoping that next year I will have better luck and I'll be able to read better books or enjoy books and not have to DNF books next year. Well, before it gets super, super dark and I just completely disappear, I shall end this video. Thank you all for watching. I would love to know what books were on your list for this year that you really did not like. And I'll see you next time. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, you know, the usual stuff. And I will see you in the next video. Thanks. Bye.